Good morning. Hope you guys are doing awesome. So it's super early in the morning. It's my day off and I have a few things to do today, so why not bring you guys along? I'm gonna show you guys how I get my morning started. One thing I am gonna warn you, my morning starts with needles. So today I have to change some of my insulin, my diabetic stuff. So warning, if you don't like needles and you don't like to see stuff like that, then you may want to skip over the next few seconds or minutes. I have been asked multiple times to show you guys how I apply my diabetic stuff. So right now I'm gonna go ahead and check my sugar. I have not had any food or anything like that, and then I'm going to apply the rest of my stuff, which is how I get like my insulin in my body, like my reservoir and my sensor and all that good stuff. So follow me. So I went ahead and I washed my hands. So the next thing that we're gonna do is get everything ready to poke. I'm gonna grab my little thing that pricks my finger. I'm gonna put a needle in there. These have to be changed every single time. I push in, I twist it, I remove it, put the little cap on, like this. I make sure that the number up here is set to 3. I don't know if you guys can see that little number right there at the top. It can be either 2 or 3. I normally go for 3 just to be on the safe side. I set this down. I go ahead and I grab my strips. And to turn this on, I just push this in like that and it turns on. It's gonna go ahead and tell me apply blood. So I don't know if you guys can see that. I'm gonna grab my alcohol and I'm going to put some alcohol on my finger, of course. I'm going to just press this little white part there. Put the blood in there. It's gonna read my sugar. 287. Right, that is kind of my, I would say, norm at the moment. Obviously it's not a normal blood sugar, but I'm still working on bringing that down from what it used to be, of course. So 287. So I showed you guys this little bag before. This is where I keep all my diabetic supplies. And I am gonna show you how I apply the next thing. Once again, if you're not a person that likes to see needles, this is a part that you may wanna skip as well. All right, so this bulky thing right here is going to help me apply my little bumblebee. And I call it a bumblebee because when I was taught how to use it, they told me that it looked like a bumblebee. See, that is a needle. I'm going to apply my sensor. This sensor right here basically checks my blood sugars every 5 minutes. So right now it's, well, it was charging, now it's done. So let's go ahead and prep this. So I open it up. This is it right here. Looks like that, a little bit creepy and weird. So I'm gonna go ahead and just push this down like so. Take it off. I know it sounds loud. This is the needle that's gonna go inside me. It's crazy. I know it sounds huge. I remember when I was learning how to apply this little guy. Oh my gosh, guys, I was sweating. I can do needles on people, but I cannot do needles on myself. Oh my god. So anyway, let me turn you guys around. Alright guys, so I am very insecure about my stomach area for 2 reasons. I am not a thin girl, and with me having to change my diabetic supplies a lot, it leaves scars. So please don't leave any mean comments because it's already hard as it is. So yeah, this is where we're going into now. I'm gonna go ahead and just apply alcohol. Today I'm going to apply my sensor here, and I'm going to apply my reservoir over here. So let's start with this side. We are gonna be grabbing this guy right here. This basically tells me where I have to put my thumb and all that stuff. It sounds loud, but it's not that bad. Let's see. So I'm gonna go right here. 1, 2, 3, and go. I'm gonna hold it for, I still jump every time because I'm just not a fan of needles. Okay, hold it for a little bit. And it stays right there. Pops out like that. The next step is I'm going to grab the sensor. I am going to put it in there until it clicks. Okay, so when we are applying that, I want to make sure that my sensor is on. Oh God, it's gonna be hard to show you guys. So sensor, it's off, so we're gonna turn it on. We're gonna scroll down and click on new sensor, start new sensor, and then okay. All right, so it's searching for my thing now. Once this turns green, there we go. It's safe to remove the sticker from the bottom. It's gonna stick to my skin that way. Now, I'm gonna grab this little sticky thing over here, pull that little bottom thing, and I'm gonna pull the needle out. And the needle looks like that. And I'm going to So my pump found it and it's warming up. I'm gonna put my little kidney sticker thing on top because it looked like kidneys, that's why I call them that. Just like so. We put one on the top and then we put one at the bottom. All right, so the next item is the reservoir. This little guy is the little guy that connects to my pump that releases my insulin. So this is also a needle. So what I do is I press it in a little bit like that. Sometimes it stays, sometimes it doesn't. So what I do is I remove, sorry, I normally don't record myself doing this, so I sort of forget my steps even though I've been doing this for a couple months now. So I remove that little tape, I twist the top, that's the needle that's gonna go inside. All right, I'm gonna turn you guys around now. I already wiped alcohol in the area. And this right here, I wanna make sure that my little string is facing down as opposed to up, so that way it can hang this way and it doesn't hang the other way, because then it has this little loop thing and it's not cute. So we're gonna go here. Sorry, it takes me a minute still, because I get scared. So I push this button here and I take it out like that. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna hold on. You can't really see because my hand's covering, but I'm gonna pull the needle out. And this is what the needle looks like. I close the cap like that. And what I do with this string is I twist here. And then I remove it because I'm gonna connect it to my pump now, to my insulin thing. I put it at the top. I have to put my insulin tube in there, so I'm going to put new reservoir, rewind. Just going to
So now I want to make sure that my thing is connected. So this is how I know if I'm gonna get insulin or not. Starts loading. Put a little paper towel here.
Yeah.
I put a little paper towel right here so that I can see if it drops because it's clear. So here we go. Okay, so my pump is already connected to my sensor. It takes about 2 hours for my pump to connect and it, you know, to warm up. What I'm gonna do now is I'm going to put what my sugar was. It was 287 and I'm going to have 8 carbs right now because I'm gonna eat. So it's going to release 12.7 units of insulin. I'm gonna say next. It's going to say that my sugar is high, of course. It's going to deliver the bolus, which is the insulin. And it's gonna ask me if I wanna calibrate. I'm gonna say yes. It's releasing my insulin as we speak right now. Once it calibrates, it'll show me my sugar here, and it's going to constantly check my sugars every 5 minutes now. All right, my loves. So, little problem right now. My plans were to bring you guys along with me to every place that I was gonna go to today because I did have a lot of things to do and I really wanted you guys to come along. But I just looked at my camera and the battery is not going to last. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave this as a how do I apply my diabetic supplies on video, and the next one it'll probably be a blog. I'll bring you guys along, but yeah, I'm all bombed because I'm like, really? Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I love you guys and I will see you all on my next video. Bye.